My second novel comes out February 5th and it's called On the Come Up. And I have to point this out because I get this question a lot. It is not a sequel or a spinoff to The Hate U Give. I honestly can't see myself writing a sequel to The Hate U Give right now, because the fact is I'd have to put Star through a whole lot, and I feel like I've put Baby Girl through enough in one book. Let's let her live her life. So On the Come Up, I actually put another girl through a whole lot. Because I'm a cruel author. It's about a 16-year-old girl named Brianna whose life is currently upside down because her mom has unexpectedly lost her job. And shut-off notices and eviction notices are just as much a part of her life as beats and rhymes. Brianna wants to be a rapper. It's her passion. She expresses herself through lyrics and hip-hop, through raps. So when she experiences some unfortunate incidents at her school where she's often labeled a hoodlum, she puts her anger and frustration into a song, which goes viral for all the wrong reasons. And suddenly she finds herself in the center of a controversy that is too big for her to control. But as her family situation is getting worse, she finds herself desperate to make it, even if it means becoming the very thing she's been made out to be. This book is my take on what it means to be young Black, especially in America, when freedom of speech isn't always free. In The Hate U Give, we started a conversation on finding your voice and what it means to have a voice and knowing that you have a voice. But I feel as if I would be doing my readers a big disservice if I didn't address the fact that so often young people are criticized and policed for how they speak. And one of the biggest ways we've criticized them and when they speak is through hip-hop. Hip-hop has often received criticism because it makes people uncomfortable. But the fact is, hip-hop has spoken for so many young people around the world. That's why it's one of the biggest genres in the world. So this book is my take on that and my look at that, and the fact that we so often tell young people how they should speak instead of listening to what they have to say.